सो हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रवीण पटवारी एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ सम्स ऑन लेवरेज. नाउ वील स्टार्ट विथ क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. स्टार्ट विथ क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. कैलकुलेट द डिग्री ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग लेवरेज, डिग्री ऑफ फाइनेंशियल लेवरेज एंड द डिग्री ऑफ कंबाइंड लेवरेज फॉर द फॉलोइंग फर्म्स एंड इंटरप्रेट द रिजल्ट्स. वी हैव बीन गिवन थ्री फर्म्स एंड वी नीड टू इंटरप्रेट द रिजल्ट्स एज वेल. ओके, सो वी हैव बीन गिवन आउटपुट, फिक्स कॉस्ट, यूनिट वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, यूनिट सेलिंग प्राइस, इंटरेस्ट एक्सपेंसेस. सो इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल कंप्यूटेशन सम. विल ड्रॉ फोर कॉलम्स. फर्स्ट इज, एज यू ऑल नो, पर्टिकुलर्स, एंड देन वी हैव फर्म पी, क्यू एंड आर. देन वी हैव फर्म पी, क्यू एंड आर. ओके, सो सेल क्वांटिटी फॉर पी इट्स 250,000. देन इट्स 1,25,000. देन इट्स 7,50,000. आफ्टर दिस वी हैव बीन गिवेन सेल प्राइस पर यूनिट. सो सेल प्राइस पर यूनिट वी हैव बीन गिवेन. सो सेल प्राइस पर यूनिट इज 7.5, 7 एंड 10. इफ वी सब्ट्रैक्ट वेरिएबल कॉस्ट पर यूनिट विच इज 5, 2 एंड 7.5, देन वी विल गेट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट. सो इट इज 2.5, 5, 2.5. देन वी विल कैलक्यूलेट टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन विच इज 2.5 इंटू 2.5 लैक्स. सो दिस कम्स टू 6,25,000, 6,25,000, 18,75,000. देन वी सब्ट्रैक्ट फिक्स कॉस्ट विच इज 5 लाख, 2.5 लाख एंड 10 लैक्स. सो 5 लाख, 2.5 लाख एंड 10 लाख. द रिजल्ट विच वी गेट इज ईबीआईटी. सो ईबीआईटी इज 1,25,000, 3,75,000 एंड 8,75,000. देन वी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट इंटरेस्ट विच इज 75,000, 25,000 एंड हियर इट्स निल. And here it's nil. Therefore, what we get is EBT. So EBT is 50,000, 350,000, 875,000. Okay, so this is the income statement, and now I am giving you all little bit of time so that you can calculate degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. Please do this. So, are you all able to do it? Did you all complete the sum? Let's discuss the answers. First is degree of operating leverage, for which the formula is contribution by EBIT. So it will be 5, 1.67 2.14. After this, we have degree of financial leverage, which is EBIT by EBT. Two point five, 1.07 and 1. Next is degree of combined leverage, which is DOL into DFL. DOL into DFL. So for this, the answer is 12.50, 1.79, 2.14. So, what conclusion can we draw? Conclusion is total risk of firm P is high while that of Q is least. Okay. So this was a very basic sum which we did. So after this, we are going to move to our next sum. Which is question number 3. Now, before doing this sum, few of the important formulas which we all know from costing, which are very important to solve the sums, just make a note of it. Break even point, when we calculate in terms of units, it is fixed cost by contribution per unit. If we calculate break even point in numbers, in value, for numbers in terms of units, it's this formula. And when we calculate break even point in value, it's the second formula, which says fixed cost by PV ratio. Now, what is PV ratio? It is also known as profit volume ratio. So, this is nothing but contribution by sales. Profit volume ratio, which is contribution by sales. Now, if we need to calculate BP numbers, then we'll use fixed cost by contribution per unit. If we need to calculate BEP in terms of value, then we'll calculate fixed cost by PV ratio. And what is PV ratio? Contribution by sales. So these three are some of the important formulas which we have studied in marginal costing. So now we'll move to question number 3. X Limited has estimated that for a new product, its break-even point is 20,000 units if the item is sold for 14 per unit and variable cost is 9 per unit. Calculate the degree of operating leverage for sales volume 25,000 units and 30,000 units. So it's a very simple sum. First, we'll calculate fixed cost. So, working note number 1. We have just now studied that BEP in terms of units, it's fixed cost by contribution per unit. Now we need to calculate fixed cost. We know how to calculate contribution per unit. It will be sale price per unit minus variable cost per unit. And break-even point is 20,000 units. So from here we can calculate fixed cost, which is 20,000 into 5, which is 1 lakh, which is 1 lakh. And now we can draw 3 columns and we can solve the remaining sum. And we can solve the remaining sums. So first column is for particulars, Next is for when the sales figure is 25,000 units. And third is for when the sales figure is 50,000 units. Okay. So, contribution per unit is 14 minus 9, which is 5. Therefore, total contribution is 25,000 into 5 and 50,000 into 5. So this comes to made a small mistake. This figure will be 30,000 units. We need to calculate for 2 units. It's for 25,000 units and for 30,000 units. I by mistake said it's 50,000, but it's 30,000 in the question. So total contribution will be 1,25,000 and 1,50,000. From total contribution, we need to subtract the fixed cost, which remains fixed, which is 1 lakh. Therefore, we get EBIT, which is 25,000 and 50,000. Now, next is degree of operating leverage, which is 25,000 by 1,25,000 and here it will be, sorry. Degree of operating leverage is 1,25,000 by EBIT. Degree of operating leverage is total contribution by EBIT. Now, first of all, in this sum, we were given break-even point in units. We needed to calculate fixed cost and we just calculated contribution per unit. Now, how to calculate contribution per unit? Sale price minus variable cost per unit. So that gives us the contribution per unit, which is rupees 5. So from there, we calculated the fixed cost, which is 1 lakh. And just a small mistake, I just misread the question. The question says calculate the degree of operating leverage for sales volume 25,000 units and 30,000 units. So it's for 25,000 and 30,000 and not 50,000. So we calculated total contribution, we subtracted fixed cost, and we got EBIT, which is 25,000 and 50,000. Next, we calculated degree of operating leverage, which is total contribution by EBIT, which is 1,25,000 by 25,000. And in this case, it's 1,50,000 by 50,000. So here it's 5 times, and here it's 3 times. So this was a very basic question. Just it included these concepts which we need to know: break-even point in units, break-even point in value, and PV ratio, which is profit volume ratio. So what is profit volume ratio? Contribution by sales, break-even point in value. It's fixed cost by PV ratio. So degree of operating leverage is contribution by EBIT, degree of financial leverage is EBIT by EBT, and degree of combined leverage is contribution by EBT. So we have calculated. So these are the basic questions on leverage. Now next, you all can copy this down if you haven't. I'll just wait for 1 minute. So now let's move on to the next question, which is question number 4. The data of two firms, Rama and Krishna, having the same PV ratio is given below. Make relevant computations and comment on their operating risks. Okay. So we have been given sales, variable cost, contribution, fixed cost, profit. We need to make some relevant contributions. Okay. So we'll make calculations of PV ratio, net profit ratio, fixed cost, break-even point, which will be in value terms, and obviously degree of operating leverage. So these 5 computations we are going to make. Now let's start one by one. Okay. So particulars, Rama, Krishna. So first is PV ratio, which is contribution by sales. So contribution for both the firms is 80,000 and sales for both the firms is 2 lakhs. So it's 80,000 by 2 lakhs, which is 40%, and here also it will be 40%. Next is net profit ratio. So net profit ratio is profit by sales. So for the first Rama it's 50,000 and for Krishna it's 30,000. So it's 50,000 by 2 lakhs, which is 25%, and for Krishna it's 30,000 by 2 lakhs, which is 15%. Now the third is fixed cost, which is given in the question. Fixed cost is 30,000 and 50,000. So Krishna has higher fixed cost. Break-even point इज फिक्स कॉस्ट बाय पीवी रेशियो. नाउ ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज फिक्स कॉस्ट बाय पीवी रेशियो. सो फिक्स कॉस्ट इज 30,000 बाय पीवी रेशियो इज 0.4 एंड हियर इट विल बी 50,000 बाय 0.4. सो इट्स 75,000 एंड 1,25,000. Next is operating leverage, which is contribution by EBIT. Which is contribution by EBIT. So contribution is 80,000 in both, and EBIT is 50,000, and for Krishna it's 30,000. So it will be 1.6 times, and here it will be 2.67 times. Now we need to interpret the results. Now see, Krishna has higher fixed cost, higher operating risk, lower profitability, and higher degree of operating leverage. We'll write this down and then we can understand. Please write down the conclusion. PV ratio is same. PV ratio is same. Krishna has higher fixed cost, therefore higher break even point, because if fixed costs are high then break even point will be higher. Okay, higher break even point, lower profits when compared to Rama. This is also reflected in high degree of operating leverage and high operating risk. Therefore, lower the degree of operating leverage, the better it is for the business. Hence, Krishna has higher operating risk than Rama. Krishna has higher operating risk than Rama. So I hope so we have interpreted some positive results from this sum. Like we got to know that lower degree of operating leverage is preferable. Okay, and a high degree of financial leverage is preferable only when the cost of borrowing is less than what we are getting by investing that money. Let me explain this. If return on capital employed is 25% and cost of capital, like cost of raising finance, is 15%, then a high degree, high DFL, then high DFL is preferred. Then high degree of financial leverage is preferred. Okay, so if the return on capital employed is 25% and the cost of borrowing is 15%, then high degree of financial leverage is preferable, otherwise it is not preferable. Okay, so this was question number 4. Now we'll do a similar kind of sum, which is question number 5. Which is question number 5. Now, Karn, Arjun, having the same profits is given below, make relevant computations and comment on their operating risks. Sales is given, variable cost is given, contribution is given, fixed cost is given, and profit is given. So, again, we'll try to calculate all those 5 figures. You all start. Again, we'll calculate all the 5 figures which we have calculated in the previous question. We'll start with particulars. Karna, Arjuna, so we'll start with PV ratio. So what is PV ratio? PV ratio is contribution by sales. PV ratio is contribution by sales. So contribution for Karna is 80,000 by 2 lakhs, which is 40%, and here it is 1 lakh by 2 lakhs, so it's 50%. Next is net profit ratio. So net profit ratio is profit by sales. 50,000 by 2 lakhs, which is 25%. And here it is 50,000 by 2 lakhs. So again it is 25%. Next, what we have done is fixed cost. So fixed cost, it's 30,000, and here it is 50,000. Next is break even point. So break even point is fixed cost by PV ratio. Fixed cost by PV ratio. So fixed cost is 30,000 and 50,000, and the PV ratio is 40% and 50%. So here it will be 75,000 and here it will be 1 lakh. Next comes operating leverage, which is contribution by EBIT. Which is contribution by EBIT. So it is 80,000 by 50,000, which is 1.6, and here it will be 1 lakh by 50,000. So it is 2 times. Again, we need to interpret the results. Fixed cost is high, though the profitability is same, break-even point is high, and DOL is high. Therefore, which firm is more risky? Arjuna. Conclusion. Arjuna has high fixed cost, has high break-even point, profits are same, हाई ऑपरेशनल रिस्क, हाई डिग्री ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग लेवरेज. ओके, नाउ इफ यू सी विच फर्म हैज अ हायर मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी. नाउ इफ द ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज हाई, द मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी इज लेस. ओके, सो वी कैन से दैट अर्जुना हैज लोअर मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी. नाउ टोटल सेल्स कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, वन इज द ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट एंड द मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी. नाउ बोथ द फर्म्स आर हैविंग इक्वल सेल्स ऑफ 2 lakhs. फॉर फर्म कर्ण द मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी विल बी 1,25,000, बट फॉर फर्म अर्जुना द मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी विल बी 1 lakh. सो इट हैज लोअर मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी. ओके, सो दिस इज द कंक्लूजन विच वी हैव ड्रॉन फ्रॉम दिस सम. यू कैन जस्ट सी दिस. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर अ मिनट. Now after this, a concept, after this we'll end today's class. It is a very important concept. When is high DFL preferred? When is high degree of financial leverage preferred? So you all can write this down. When ROC is greater than interest rate. Now what does this mean? This means company earns a higher return on investment. Company earns a higher return on investment than it has to pay for borrowed funds. The difference between EBIT and the cost of debt funds, the difference between EBIT and the cost of debt funds the difference between EBIT and the cost of debt funds would enhance the earnings of equity shareholders, would enhance the earnings of equity shareholders. Okay, so when this is the case, high DFL is justified. High DFL is justified. So I hope so we have done few basic sums, and in the next class we'll be doing more sums on leverage, and we'll be going in depth in leverage analysis. Like, I will make you all note down a table in which we'll discuss when operating leverage is high and DFL is high. Like, we'll make some combinations: high, 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 low, low, high, low, low. So we'll make few combinations of DOL and DFL, and we'll see which combination suits us the best. So thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe, and break the chain of the coronavirus.